Good morning. Welcome to today's assembly. As you can see, I'm going to be talking a bit about safeguarding today, what safeguarding looks like at Carshalton High School for Girls, how you learn about safeguarding, and what you can do if you're worried for yourself or for one of your friends. So what is safeguarding? Safeguarding is making sure that the people around us are not at risk of harm. At Carshalton Girls, this means that we are looking out for signs and indicators that you may feel at risk of harm, both in and outside of school. It means at Carshalton Girls we are here to listen. If you are concerned for yourself or a friend, we are happy to listen to that concern. It means that all staff at Carshalton Girls, teachers, support staff, even the canteen staff, have received training on how to identify and notice those signs and indicators, how to listen to concerns, and what to do with that concerns, how and who to report it to. In school, we have a safeguarding team who are able to follow up any of those concerns, to talk to you about your worries, and to guide you through the next steps. As you know, we cannot promise to keep secrets, but we do promise that your information will only be shared with those that absolutely need to know. Part of our role as adults is to have a duty of care for you. This means that sometimes we do have to report what you tell us to other people outside of school, as they are the ones that are better placed to keep you safe. We will always talk you through this process where we can, and explain why it is that we need to do so. There are, of course, some exceptions, and sometimes concerns are raised with us or brought to us outside of school hours, and we can't talk to you immediately. But if that concern indicates to us that you are at immediate risk of harm, we may have no alternative but to involve other agencies, such as the police, to make sure that you are safe. So I'm sure you'll have seen some of these posters around school. They indicate who the safeguarding team are. They can be found in teachers' classrooms, in offices, on the corridors, and in some of our display boards. The safeguarding team are a group of teachers who have had further and in some cases extensive training around safeguarding concerns. The team is led by myself, with Miss Newman and Mrs. Warren. The team then extends out to your pastoral team and to the senior leadership team. In most instances, if you report a concern, one of the safeguarding team will be alerted to this, and it will be one of us that works with you and who you've reported it to ensure that the appropriate measures are put in place to ensure the safety of yourself or your friend. So what might happen if you come and talk to a member of staff regarding a safeguarding concern? Well, there's several things that we will do. Firstly, we will listen carefully to what it is you are telling us. We may ask you some questions or to explain a little bit more, just so that we truly understand what it is you're reporting to us, what the risk of harm is, and who might be at risk of harm. If you're talking to us around a concern to do with neglect or physical, sexual or emotional abuse, we are likely to want to report that on to other agencies, especially if that is happening outside of school. But wherever it is happening, we will need further guidance around that, especially if a crime has taken place, which in most instances it will have done. We might need to contact the emergency police, but the chances are we will work through 101, which is a non-emergency police line, and we may need to contact the Children's First Contact Centre, which is the Sutton Hub for safeguarding, or the Croydon or Merton equivalent, depending on where you live. This does mean that other people will want to come and talk to you about the issue that you have raised, but we will be there to support you through that process as it happens. However, there are other safeguarding concerns that possibly don't need to be reported to outside agencies that we can support you with in school. And we are always on the lookout for signs that you may be at risk of harm from some of those areas. These could include online activity. As you know, all of the school devices are monitored and any flags from that come directly to me. And I can see some of your activity online if it is considered risky behaviour, and that will be followed up initially inside of school working with our pastoral team, but it might include referrals to outside agencies such as the police, again, if a crime is occurring. We can also support you around things to do with county lines, gang activity, poor or declining mental health, all of which are indicators that there is a safeguarding concern. You are already taught a lot about safeguarding, although you might not recognise it as learning about safeguarding. Within your personal development sessions, whether that be the afternoon tutor time sessions or the whole days that we put aside for personal development, you will be learning about safeguarding, ways to keep yourself safe and ways to keep your friends and family safe. Some of the themes that you will cover while you're at Carshalton Girls, and different themes are covered in different ways with different year groups, so you might not have come across all of these yet, are themes such as child criminal exploitation, child sexual exploitation, FGM, abuse such as physical, emotional and sexual abuse, as I've already mentioned, harmful sexual behaviour, including peer-on-peer abuse, county lines, gang activity, radicalisation, honour-based abuse, online safety and online grooming. That's just a small number. There are lots of other themes that you cover in your PD sessions which come under the general topic of safeguarding. All of those sessions are really important, and it's really useful for you to keep the signposting pages that are in your PD booklets to hand, so that if you are worried or concerned about any of those areas, either for yourself or a friend, you know who you can contact, especially if you are outside of school and it's urgent that you report something. If you have a concern or a worry for yourself or a friend, we absolutely encourage you to talk to someone. Talk to a trusted adult. That can be any member of staff in Carshalton Girls. That member of staff might not be able to drop everything in the middle of a lesson to listen to you, but they will arrange another time to sit and listen carefully to what it is you have to tell them. We know it can be difficult. It can feel like you are betraying a friend's confidence, that you're snitching. However, by sharing what you know, by showing that you're worried, what you're doing is being a great friend, getting them access to the help that they deserve and may be too scared to ask for themselves. If you don't feel able to come and talk to a member of staff, you can email them or use the SHARP system. As you know, you can access this via the school website, or you can download the app to your phone. Please remember to include the name of the person that you're worried about. If you're unsure, grab one of our What If leaflets. There is one particularly that says, I am worried about a friend. Okay, that gives you some guidelines of where and who you can go and talk to, both in and outside of school. But there are some that are specifically targeted at different safeguarding or wellbeing issues. If it's outside of school hours, such as the holidays or an evening, there are still places that you can go to for help, support and guidance. Charity lines such as Childline or the Samaritans have 24/7 phone lines which you can contact. They also have chat facilities via their websites that you will be able to access. Talk to a trusted adult, either within your family or within your friendships family groups. Contact the police. Someone is always available on 101 to talk through your concern, or if someone is at immediate risk of harm, you can of course call 999. Group leaders such as cadets, scouts, St John's Ambulance, wherever you are part of a youth group, the leaders of those groups will have completed safeguarding training in a very similar way to we have in school and will know how to get help and support for you. If you're still unsure, you can go into any hospital, any doctor's surgery or any pharmacy and ask for help and support from the staff in there. They will be happy to support you and listen to you and get guidance around your safeguarding concern. And finally today is that safeguarding concerns are rare. Most people are not out to cause you harm. However, we want you to be and to feel safe, to be aware that sometimes there are dangers and unfortunately not everyone is trustworthy. It is important that you're aware that these things can happen so that you know how to protect yourself and your friends. I hope you have a lovely day. Thank you for listening.